past day and a half. I would now request Allama Aqeel Jillali sahab. Allama sahab, is tarah ke 3-4 sawal aaye hain pichle 2-3 din ke andar ke ye mufti sahab qibla ne jawab bhi iska diya lekin English mein diya hai. To ab main chahta hu ke Urdu mein aap bata dein kyunki maine ek do aur sawal bhi karne hain to mukhtasar alayhisalaam kehna Hazrat Imam Hussain رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ کے بعد کچھ لوگ کہتے ہیں کہ علیہ السلام کہتے ہیں تو اس کا ڈیفرنس کیا ہے علیہ السلام کہنے میں اور رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ کہتے ہیں
جی بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم بنیادی طور پہ شہزاد بھائی چونکہ ہم اہل السنہ ہیں اور ہمارا جو نظام ہے وہ اسی تحت چلے گا جو ہمارے اکابرین فرما گئے ہیں اعلیٰ حضرت عظیم المرتبہ شاہ احمد رضا خان فاضل محدث بریلوی رحمۃ اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ ہوں یا حضور صدر الشریعہ مولانا امجد علی صاحب آزمی ہوں رحمۃ اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ یا جتنے بھی ہمارے اکابرین ہیں وہ اس بات پر متفق ہیں کہ انبیاء اور فرشتوں کے جب نام لیے جائیں گے ملائکہ کرام کے تو ان کے نام کے ساتھ علیہ السلام کہا جائے گا اور باقی جب صحابہ پاک کا یا اہل بیت اطہار کا نام لیا جائے گا تو ان کے نام کے ساتھ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ کہا جائے گا اور اس کے بعد اولیاء اعظم کا نام لیا جائے گا تو رحمۃ اللہ تعالیٰ علیہ کہا جائے گا اچھا یہاں پر ایک اور بات میں جو عرض کرنا چاہتا ہوں جیسے ایک کالر کہہ رہے تھے کہ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ جو یعنی یہ سمجھتے ہیں یہ کوئی بات ہی نہیں ہے اللہ تعالیٰ یہ ڈگری عطا فرما رہا ہے یہ اللہ تعالیٰ انعام عطا فرما رہا ہے رضی اللہ عنہم ورضوا عنہ
سبحان اللہ
یہ اتنا بڑا انعام ہے کہ ہر بندہ آج بڑے سے بڑا مفتی ہو بڑے سے بڑا قاری ہو بڑے سے بڑا عالم ہو بڑے سے بڑا پیر ہو اس کی ساری عبادت اس لیے ہے ہر اچھا کام اس لیے ہے کہ مالک تو راضی ہو جا وہ اللہ کو راضی کرنے کے لیے اس کا ہر کام ہے ہر بندہ یہ چاہتا ہے کہ مجھ سے میرا اللہ راضی ہو جائے تو رضی اللہ کا مطلب یہ ہے کہ اللہ ان سے راضی ہے تو ہم جب یہ کہتے ہیں کہ امام حسین رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ تو اس پر اگر کوئی اعتراض کرتا ہے کہ رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ نہ کہو تو کیا وہ یہ سمجھتا ہے کہ امام حسین سے اللہ راضی نہیں ہے یا امام حسن سے اللہ راضی نہیں ہے تو اس لیے یہ بات اہل سنت کا یہ شعار ہے کہ ہمیشہ سے رہا ہے اور اگر کوئی ایک آدھا کوئی ایسی بات کر دیتا ہے تو اس کی اہمیت اس لیے نہیں ہے کیونکہ دیکھا یہ جائے گا کہ اہل سنت ہمیشہ سے کیا کہتے آئے ہیں تو ہمیشہ سے جو کہتے آئے ہیں وہ یہی بات ہے کہ انبیاء اور فرشتوں کے لیے علیہ السلام اور صحابہ پاک اور اہل بیت کے لیے رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ
ٹھیک ہے ہمارے ساتھ رضی اللہ عنہ اور علیہ السلام whether it's what's the difference
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim alhamdulillah we've learned so far regarding the crimes that were committed against Ahlul Bayt and the crimes specifically committed against Imam Hussein generally in Islam we go according to what Alamas have said according to Aqabirin or Ulama or great scholars like what al-Shafi'i say what al-Bukhari say if you open al-Bukhari Sahih al-Bukhari and you go to the chapter al-Manaqib which means virtues under the chapter of the virtues generally there's a chapter about the virtues of Fatima al-Zahra this is the title of the chapter which Imam al-Bukhari himself uses the word alayhisalaam Allah alayha he uses this word reflecting that it is permissible that it is allowed my own sheikh in Morocco rahmatullah alayhi said or my sheikh said the brother said Abdullah bin Siddiq al-Ghumari rahmatullah the grand muhaddithun of scholars of hadith who were the teachers of Sayyid Muhammad bin Ali al-Makki al-Malik rahimahullah they very clearly wrote a treatise on this subject is it jaiz in shariat to say radiyallahu anhu or alayhi salam now the dalil that was used that it is allowed that it is jaiz in sharia is this I have in front of me bukhari and this is manaqib it's in the chapter it says this it says bab manaqibi qara'bati rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam that this is a chapter regarding the virtues of the prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's family then he says al-bukhari saying this he says wa manaqibati and he said this is the virtues wa fatimata alayhi salam binti nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam wa qala an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam fatimatu sayyidatu nisa'i ahli al-jannah he says bukhari rahmat imam al-bukhari the imam of ahli sunnah wal jamaa or imam or scholar who authored this famous book the most authentic book after the quran is the bukhari his sahih book
yeah.
in this chapter bukhari rahmatullah alayhi very clearly says that this is also a chapter regarding the virtues of Fatima may Allah peace be upon her
okay.
so let me explain this because yeah. this is very important because every all the scholars of our time
yeah.
so give me a bit of time just to explain this So the issue is it jaiz? Did the ulama, did the akabirin, Imam Taftazani in his aqaid allowed it? If you go to what Zahabi said, Al-Zahabi allowed it. Ibn Hajar in his Fatul Bari, many times Ibn Hajar will use the word Fatima when he says Salam Alayha, when he used the word Hussein alayhi salam. We use it because this is the sunnah from the Quran. We don't do it because other people do it. We don't look at them. Like, we don't say it's going to give them benefit. No. If it's going to give them benefit, then why talk about Jesus or Musa? It's going to give other people.
But don't you think that, keeping that different?
If somebody's saying radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, you're seeing the difference between the people who are saying alayhi salam.
The question, forget the people, the question is...
No, you can't forget the people. What I would like to say is, I wouldn't like any of the panel if you don't mind, because I don't want to go into a discussion. No. This is between the presenter and the... the thing is, there is a difference, and...
Let me just interrupt, because time's limited. The point is, it's not about the differences. There is a difference. Yeah. We know who the Ahlul Bayt are. We know who the Sahaba are. Ali is from the Ahlul Bayt and he's from
but
the
this
Sahaba.
But this is where you are confusing the... Will you let me talk and speak?
You invited me, so let me talk and explain the point. The question is, is it jaiz in Sharia?
Mm.
Sharia is not what Shezad says or Muhammad Umar or what Fulan Alim says. No.
Yeah.
Sharia is Quran and Sunnah. Sharia is what the Akabirin ulama said. Bukhari allowed it. Imam al-Bukhari allowed it. Imam Taftazani allowed it. Ibn Hajar allowed it. Amdud al-Qari's author, Badruddin al-Aini allowed it. Okay. Imam Ibn Hajar al-Haythami allowed it. Mullah Ali Qari allowed it. These are all scholars, Sunni ulama. Your virtues or your comment has no value comparable to them or my comments.
Mm-hmm.
It is permissible. It is allowed. It is allowed to use those words.
I've got the fatwa of what Imam Ahmed Raza Hamrelvi says.
Let me finish my point. The point is, I'm not here to debate with you.
Yeah.
Allah has a rahmatullah is
ulama. No, because the debate is just that I don't want to confuse the viewers.
We're not confusing them. I'm making a point. Yes, Sunni ka nazar. Who said this is Sunni?
Okay, I'm not going to go. I don't want to go into that. I want to stop the discussion there. But
I will now go to Muhammad Umar Sahib, and Allah Sahib, if you could kind of give your final remarks.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. First of all, I show my appreciation to my channel, the management, to Brother Arif, to Brother Abdul, Brother Zakir, and all the management here for putting up a fantastic show again to inform the Ummah about the sacrifices of the Ahlul Bayt, what they did and what Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam did on that honorable day. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put into our heart the love of the Ahlul Bayt. For the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that only a mu'min will love them and only the munafiqs will hate them, and those who have nifaq will be for the hellfire, as demonstrated by our ulama. And we pray that we learn from the great sacrifice that our imam made on that day, the sacrifice of knowledge, the sacrifice of life, the sacrifice of everything, the biggest sacrifice an individual can give, which is his blood. And we hope and we pray that you learn from his honorable life, that you put that message, that core message, which for 1400 years, people from every generation, every Yazidi generation, every Nawasib have come and have tried to belittle it and tried to accumulate this type of message to show that Islam is against Ahlul Bayt. Bring up the flag bearers of Ahlul Bayt and announce to the world that Ahlul Bayt are from Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ahlul Bayt, we Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah love them, they are part of us, and we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us die on the Iman and the love of Ahlul Bayt, inshaAllah.
Ameen. Bahut shukriya, Alama Muhammad Umar Sahib. I thank you once again, Mufti Fazl Akim Suhani Sahib, Alama Hafiz Aqeel Jillali Sahib, and Alama Nabil Afsal Sahib, Alama Muhammad Umar Sahib. Jazakumullah khair for everyone coming, mashaAllah, and rounding the program up beautifully.